Okay, welcome back to round three in Blue Moon. Blue Moon, I saw you standing alone. I'm gonna keep this hand this time. I hope you guys enjoy me doing things like misclicking and accidentally mulliganing my hand, because even if that happens, we're still having a good time, I think. So long, Snapcaster Mage. That's real sad. And we still won handily last round, so. Our opponent's name is Tarmo Fate, so what are the odds that they're playing Jund? 100%, okay. Oh, my name is Tarmo Fate, and all I do is play Jund decks. Well, that's interesting, Tarmo Fate. Why would you do that? Do you not like other decks?
I just like Tarmogoyf.
What about Fate? What does that have to do with your name?
I like Jundex.
Well, it's been good talking to you. This has been an interview with Tarmo Fate. Well, like in Grimlovmance or something. Snapcaster's looking like it's in poor shape right now. Alright, so I got four cards. We got two leaks. Seems like an okay ratio. I will kill this. I will find this Grimlovamancer, and I will kill him. I have a very specific set of lightning bolts. Are you gonna use that bad boy? You got it. Burn my face. Right in the face. Look at all these beautiful baby lands. We're gonna play this island here. If something crazy like a Blood Moon comes down, I wanna make sure we have enough islands to cast our cryptic command that does not exist. Alright, so they have five cards. We still have two counterspells. Play a Dark Confidant. Why aren't you playing things? I don't understand. Are you playing around these mana leaks that you don't know I have? Cryptic command. Oh, dang it. Maybe they just have. What if they have four more lands in hand? Wouldn't that be funny? Like, wouldn't that be just comical? We'd never know. Oh, you're going to Culligan's Command? To get Grimmy back? The Grimster? The Grimmarino? No, man. Ain't nobody got time for that. Yeah, oh yeah, you got it. Two cards. Now we're talking. I assume they're going to have another land. What a crazy assumption. Yeah, I was right. Nailed it. Blood Moon. I didn't nail that. I will use this one to cast this. I don't want this. Dang it. Bottom you, top you, cuz you're a good dude. Uranium fever has gone and got me down. A little Fallout reference there. People keep asking me why I don't have jazz in my videos anymore. I used to play a good amount of jazz. And the reason is that when I did that, I would get copyright claims from YouTube regularly, like two a day. And I think it either silences the videos or it takes them down. I'm not sure which one. Either one, it's not ideal. So you can't really create content that you're trying to monetize, either me or Channel Fireball, that has copywritten material in it. You're going to eat a Snapcaster, but you don't really have a way to eat anything else. So you can eat one thing because you only have... Oh, I'll get your Snapcaster. You got it, man. Uranium fever got me, Gearhulk. Alright, sweet. Feeling okay about this hand now. We do have a Torrential Gearhulk into Mana Leak. Or even Lightning Bolt if you play something silly. Or nothing, I suppose. Could have also used the Engineered Explosives to kill the Scavenging Ooze, which honestly might have been better. But maybe we want to save this for like Tarmogoyfs. Because that's the thing, we can't really deal with that easily right now. Glimmer. Glimmer! Okay, I'll accept. I'll accept your offering, Blue Moon deck.
Sorry, I didn't understand the question I heard.
That was the Amazon Echo. Apparently, Alexa heard her name, but I didn't call it, so someone else must. Give me a Blood Moon. Give me a Flood Strand. That's really what I meant. Look, we don't have anything to do here. I could be bashing with this Torrential Gear Hulk, but the thing you want to do with a deck like this is run them out of cards. And we can do that if we get the value off of Torrential Gear Hulk, but if we don't, then it's just sad days. I think we're just going to Engineer Explosives here because it's a fine thing to do. I was hoping they'd play a second one. That would be the most baller thing ever, right? Oh, I'm just checking, and now I'm going to play a second Tarmogoyf. Oh, well, that's interesting. A red, a blue. Engineered explosives for two. So one of my concerns is that if we crack this right now, we don't have enough mana to also Cryptic Command. We just have enough mana Link. So if they play something like Liliana, it gets a little scary. So I think we're actually taking four here. We're going to assume they don't have multiple more Lightning Bolts. Or Kolaghan's Command. God, Kolaghan's Command is such a good card. It's unbelievable. Yep, that's exactly why we didn't. Counter draw. Well, that's interesting. Uranium Fear. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we can pop and Gear Hulk here. Which is exactly where you want to be. That's where we want to be. Tarmogoyf's also a 5-6. I probably would have played Liliana first. But who knows, you know? Anything could happen. Boom. I have four cards. So if we Torrential Gear Hulk and Cryptic Command... I don't care about that stupid wizard. Stupid wizard. I'm still gonna Torrential Gear Hulk. I just want to get this guy out of my hand. And I want to. And we have Academy Ruins, so we can actually put him back on top and get another. I mean, if they have Terminator, it's still fine. It's actually a 3-for-1. We get rid of Dark Confidant, Terminate, and we draw a card. Counterspell, draw a card. That guy. Old Snapperino. So, this is going to cost 3. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, let's do it. 1, 2... This guy. Put you back on the tippy top. Drawed it. Your turn. Infinite Torrential Gear Hulks and infinite Engineered Explosives actually could be good against decks like this. Sure. I mean, now that we have Academy Ruins, I feel like we can actually play Torrential Gear Hulk here, Lightning Bolt for free, and then play another Gear Hulk if they kill it. So we hit okay here, right? Waiting for Tarmo Fate. Pay costs. Alright, this is only going to last for so long, just so you know. One, two. I'll just keep drawing this guy. He's very good. How do you stop infinite 5/5s when you're Jund? Infinite 5/6s. One more time with feeling. Let's get Lightning Bolt again. And we'll just keep on bolting your brain. Puts you on a 2-turn clock now. Oh, that's interesting. It does shut off our Academy Ruins, though, so that's a sad day. Is that better than them simply having access to only black and red mana? Because, I mean, if they do have a removal spell... Yeah, I think we're just going to keep it up. So you clearly drew Raging Ravine. So what did you have that you were holding? Maelstrom Pulse. Sure. I'm going to draw this guy if that's okay with you. Yeah, this is... So we can also Mana Leak, then Torrential Gearhulk Mana Leak if they try to play something. I guess we just play this and let it resolve? Not even going to play Mana Leak, just going to let it resolve so you go to 2. And if you can kill it, we put it back on top again, and then you're just getting ground out of cards pretty effectively. The final Kolaghan's Command. Oh, Huntmaster of the Fells. They took a Mana Leak? I guess because we could have countered this guy, sure. Go back to 4. Man. So I feel like we can just play Engineer Explosives for 0 here. We finally get to draw a card, which is nice. And it's a Blood Moon. So now you have to block. And you're in top deck mode. So I think we just play Blood Moon here and try to dodge Terminate or Kolaghan's Command, right? Sure. Yep. Alright, sweet. I mean, they could have drawn it, but... Yeah, we would have hit a Gearhulk, another Gearhulk in 2 turns, so it seems fine. Alright, so against Jund. I'm not sure if I even like Engineered Explosives. Like, they never play more than... Like, there are rare situations where they have more than one 2-drop in play at the same time. It's nice to keep recycling them, but, you know, like we figured out in the first game, like, it's just... This, I feel like this is a more rare of a game where it's like that usually doesn't happen. I do like Roast as it kills everything. I do like Negate as it deals with things like Liliana. Spell Snare is also fantastic for the 2-drops. I think we're just going to submit like this. I don't see Dispel being as good. Yeah, we're going to ship this hand. If this hand had a Serum Visions, we would 100% keep it. This is significantly better. And we'll keep you on top as well. Which means we're going to start with this. Well, actually, we don't have to start on the place. Or on the draw, rather. So we don't have to start with Island. We can start with Polluted Delta to get another. Oh, that's so sad. Oh, so long, Serum Visions. Not the most exciting pull, but still a pretty relevant cog in our machine. In our Blue Moon machine. Let's say my jazz band, the Blue Moon machine. I'm gonna just play this guy.
Oh, I drew another Serum Visions. How lucky.
That's where they thought sees us and take Cryptic Command or Torrential Gearhulk. Or they just play Tarmogoyf. 1-2 Tarmogoyf. Oh, wow. That's. I literally had to hit a. Oh my god, you're so lucky. It's gonna be a land now. Yep. Magic is an unfortunate game of sadness. That's a true story. I wrote it myself. It's called Magic is an Unfortunate Game of Sadness. Let's get an island. Now we have three islands. Man, Serum Vision and Snapcaster Mage, the value is so real. Here comes Liliana. Oh. That's not the Liliana I'm terribly afraid of. That one gives us some time. Alright, well, we are sorely lacking in early turn plays here, so. However, we can bounce Liliana and counter something if they play something this turn, like a Huntmaster of the Fells. No, they not this turn, because we don't actually have anything to do. So Liliana's going to go to 6. We're going to play our 5th land. Liliana's going to go to 7. We're going to play our 6th land if we draw it. And then we're going to disallow the ultimate. Just kidding. There's no disallows in this deck. Yep. Oh, that's good. Oh, that's nice. Our hand is actually very good right now. We can Cryptic Command and Spell Snare or Lightning Bolt if we have to. They have 3 cards in hand. We technically have 6 because of Cryptic Command and Torrential Gearhulk. That's a good feeling. As you can see, this Liliana's not really doing much, so. Look at all their beautiful basic lands they're getting. That's wonderful. So proud. What are you doing here? Thought Sneeze. Get out of here with that. Oh, that is a 6 land, which is nice. He's protecting something. He is. He's got a little G-Hulk. That's old T-G-Hulk. Yep. So we actually have to Lightning Bolt that. Reason being... if we can't... Like, they can just ultimate it next turn as soon as they get priority, so... Oh, another land. Another precious land. Oh, I do like having Torrential Gearhulk and... Academy of Ruins now. That's pretty baller. Just play Huntmaster of the Fells here. Heck, play anything. Oh, I'm so glad they did that. Do Do we want two blue? I think we want it. Or two red? I think we do. Torrential Gear Hulk. And now we can Lightning Bolt Liliana. And if they kill this guy, well, you know how that ends. Oh my god, do we get to untap and go to the... Oh my god. What? That's insane. Do we just get to kill Liliana here? Does our Torrential Gearhulk survive? Did you let us untap with Torrential Gearhulk when we have another Torrential Gearhulk to get Cryptic Command? No way is this real life. I'm gonna make you use something better if you want to kill this guy. You don't have anything better? Oh boy. This is exciting. Something's happening. Oh yeah, you got it. Deal. Oh, that's awkward. And you have two cards still. I'm just gonna keep Torrential Gearhulk until I have to use it. Because there's a Cryptic Command in my graveyard. Okay. That's the end. Alright, I'll see you guys in round 4.